Institute of Levantine Studies. And this institute is actually an institute proposing this kind of interdisciplinary, cross-disciplinary, transdisciplinary type of subjects to be addressed from different corners, bringing together different type of experts. So, Professor Grigorescu, the floor is yours.
I hope you understood I am an outsider. For the many delays, you understood that the subject I'm going to think is not directly linked to the blue growth, to the blacks. But I'm disappointed to be. My subject is very closely linked to sustainable development of the region. Present a very successful worldwide story on sustainable development of the region, and addresses a message to the universities to become driving forces in regional development based on some previous So, I will speak about one resource of sustainable development of the region that proved to be of an exceptional value, giving rise to an explosion of regions in the world developed based on their heritage, but not independently, but in a very holistic way. As you know, heritage includes outstanding objects, sites of a scientific value, of a cultural value, of an aesthetic value. It might be considered of a local, regional, national, or even international, on the top being worldwide heritage list. You know there are two groups. Natural, that includes, from the scientific point of view, two main groups, that is so-called in modern terms biodiversity, animating for the examples of outstanding value, scientific, aesthetic value on this species of plants and the animals, habitats and so. And also the support of the animated life, that is inanimated one. It's not a proper word, but that is geodiversity. On the other side, there is culture, also with two sides, the tangible, in which I prefer to put also underwater ruins or ships, just to make the connection with the seminar or with the symposium. And also intangible, that refers to the oral traditions, the recording, the art. The holistic approach to the values of the regions, as I said, throughout the world, led to an impressive development of geoparks, because this is the type of region that in the last 20 years get a tremendous number with a lot of important achievements, with a lot of lessons to be known. The program who launched that development some 22 years ago, exactly in 1998, is UNESCO, International Geoscience and Geoparks Program. Following 1998, more than 150 regions in the world, most of them in Europe, because Europe was the place where the geopark started, having areas up to some 10,000 of kilometers, are not restricted areas, but large areas, were developed with a lot of differences between them related to the specific regional things, but with some common things. One of these is the holistic management of the values of the region. There are, as you saw, some 75 geoparks now. The number is continuously increasing. Every September, when UNESCO organizes a special conference on the geoparks, new aspiring geoparks are coming, and only very few of them are admitted because the conditions are really very strict, and the condition is not yet forever. Every 4 years, an area is re-evaluated and re-evaluated, so the project is going continuous to the good things. The other rather 75 geoparks are in Asia. Most of them are in China. China is by far the country that leads. Only China has, I think, 32 UNESCO geoparks. Now, Japan with some 9 geoparks, and all the others are distributed very few in Africa, in Canada, and Mexico, not in the United States, but I understood recently that they started an initiative, as Russia, because these big countries didn't agree for the beginning at least. They have another system of developing the values of the region, but now they are coming into the. We are very proud that Romania was among the first countries that got the geopark. Unfortunately, remained the only one. But we tried, and I declare you, I like the places in Dobrogea to have a geopark, and studies already for the last 2 years started finding, selecting different values of Dobrogea from Ostrov to Tulcea and Danube Delta in order to find. Thanks to Professor Skolka, who from the very beginning
applaud him.
In spite of his many, many duties, he's also very much interested, I think so, attracted by this project, because this is a project in a program, Dobrogea, the witness of the culture and civilization of Levant, that has also other projects. I will run quickly. Indeed, the Hacek Geopark that was established in 2004 nationally, 2005 recognized by UNESCO. I have to tell you that UNESCO almost signed a letter in white at that time, because the value of the nature and culture was so big and so convincing, so well presented by the publication, because they didn't have any restriction. Restrictions came afterwards, after 4 years, when we started getting yellow cards, because management is another aspect in the geopark. So, not less than 18 species of dinosaur. What is interesting, they are small. Most of the dinosaurs are big, but the dinosaurs from Transylvania are small. They are known as the dwarf dinosaurs of Transylvania. Paradoxically, in the paleobiological assembly, there is the largest flying creature ever lived. You know the time, contemporary with dinosaur, pterosaur, that has the name of the region, Hacekopteris, is recognized as the largest flying creature that ever lived. Dinosaur eggs, a lot of places, incubation places that were discovered only in the last 25 years, while the dinosaur were known since end of the 19th century. of course, rare plants and animals that add this natural value, exceptional nature value of the region, exceptional cultural heritage with archaeological sites with the oldest church built by stone, by bricks and stones, and Sush famous. Also tangible and intangible culture. As in the other geoparks, the tourism is organized in a holistic way, meaning the touristic trails combine places of a natural interest with those of a cultural one. Places historical or with places depicting some handicrafts and such. So they are selected. In this way, the visitors get wider knowledge on the area. And what is very important, by this holistic approach, the people start to understand the cultural value of the nature that is exceptionally important, and make the awareness of the people on the needs of protection the nature. We are deeply working on showing what are, in a concrete way, the cultural values of the nature. Of course, I'll jump on this because, you know, there are two strategic approaches in building a geopark. One is top-down, in which a small group of people, usually outsiders to the region, but which know very well the area from different points of view, start making the partnership, convincing people, authorities, first of all, the other stakeholders, up to the community that are at the bottom. They are the beneficiary, but they are in this strategic approach at the bottom. The other one is with the community at the top, and they start to add, to bring the other stakeholders, authorities, universities in this. The Hatzik Geopark was built based on the university. This was a driving force. A small group of people from different departments of the university that had previous studies, deep studies on the region, starting convincing the people, starting organizing things together with them, showing that the involvement of the university in a region is very important in their project, starting giving lessons to them. It was not so successful that you may understand, for my enthusiasm, it was very, very difficult, but anyway, the result was that we it was organized as such. The bottom-up approach is very much practiced by the Western European countries. The people who know better the value of the region just from the inside of the locality, they are more skilled in managing a project. Contrary, in the general, not in all, Eastern European countries, somebody from outside is necessary to come and to convince people that their region is extremely important and there are solutions to develop it. Okay, at the base of the this approach, it's a project for the universities outside the Citadel world. It was also presented to UNESCO, acronym Inside of the Outside, that demonstrates the experience of universities working with the regions. It was a long Erasmus thematic network project, but it used the experiences of the HACEC, this international project. And of course, there are a lot of benefits from both sides from this cooperation. I just listed some of them. Very important is the first one, the collaboration of the universities with the regions, with the, first of all, with their administration, create a new environment for the university directly linked to the current problem of the region, gives the student the possibility to develop their practical work, and the teachings are much more close to the reality of the region than before. I will not read all of this because, you know, time's done. Anyway, we come at the message. I mentioned that there is a program that was initiated by the Institute of Advanced Study from the Culture and Civilization of Levant. For the very beginning, 2 years ago, in cooperation with universities of Vilnius, but the same university, in fact, it's a small department of natural sciences, but hopefully this will increase the number of departments involved in this program. That includes several projects. I don't know if you can read them. It includes also the establishment, as I said, of the UNESCO Geopark in Dobroja, and the studies already started in field for the last 2 summers. The entire Dobroja, not all the places, but as I said, from Ostrov to Tulsa, every day, together with a small group of students, researchers, professors, we visited itineraries that included every day a place of biological importance, Natura 2000 usually, a geological monument, an archaeological site, just to make the importance of this the type of political approach in treating the heritage. And of course, Dobroja is extremely rich. I can tell you, I worked in Dobroja for the first time some 40 years ago in the Kobadin area. I made some studies, I published a study, and I came back after some 30, 80 years and knowing much more and much better on this marvelous region with a lot of archaeological sites of Hellenistic, of Roman, of Byzantine, most of them combining all the periods. Unfortunately, most of them missing enough money to continue the work. Exceptional rich biodiversity with plants and different types of animals, with geological, okay, my field directly, Dubrovnik in northern, quarry from Dubrovnik, numulites, the limestone is numulites from which Adam Plissy and all the area which the citadel was built from distance, Topalu, Agigiol, and at the end is Kea, the reefs, Jurassic reefs from Kea, that in fact is the area on which we started developing the Geopark project. It's an area that includes Trigușor, Kea, Grădina area, with different cultural sites like Ulmetum, like the Cassian area, like the Adam cave and so on, but also some other of natural importance. Of course, the students are very interested in participating. Unfortunately, their program is not very well connected to this, but as I said, hopefully this message that I sent to the university will be better understood, and the number of students will be involved, because indeed such a big project needs a lot of work divided in different aspects, economic, social, natural, culture and so on. Thank you very much.